Welcome to our demonstration on local variables. This video consists of two main parts. First, we will look at the four different types of variables in Hopscotch, and then we will take a closer look at how to use local variables. You don't need to code and follow along in this video. I'll be demonstrating with some examples. So feel free to put this video on full screen. While you're watching the video, also feel free to pause and rewind whenever you like. Let's get started. Part 1. Variables in Hopscotch. A variable stores information. This can be a number or some text information, for example. This information is known as the value of the variable. Keeping this information in a variable lets objects perform calculations and share information with each other. When you use a set variable block to set a variable to be a value for the first time, this is known as declaring the variable. A variable will have a default value of 0 if it is not declared. Scope is where an object can access the value of a variable in code. In Hopscotch, there are four levels at which objects can access the value of a variable. These are user variables, game variables, object variables, and local variables. Game variables have values that can be accessed by all objects in the game, and they are the same value for all objects. User variables are game variables that keep their values between plays of a project and are unique to each user who plays the project. Object variables have values that are unique for every object. These include things like X position, Y position, size, and so on. Local variables exist only in a container. You can specify which container it exists in by dragging the block where you have declared the variable. We will explore local variables further in the next section. If you'd like to learn more about variables in Hopscotch in general, check out our help doc on variables in Hopscotch on help.gethopscotch.com. Part 2. Local variables. How to create a local variable. To create a local variable, you can drag out a set variable block. The first blank bubble of the set variable block will automatically be selected and the variables keyboard will appear. Then, under the local variable section, tap New Variable. When you set a variable to be a value for the first time by using the set variable block, this is known as declaring the variable. Using local variables. I will first demonstrate local variables in this timer project. In this project, there is a simple text timer that will count down from 10. The counter variable is a local variable. Here is the first property of local variables. A local variable will exist for the container where it is declared, and the containers that are inside, except for custom abilities and custom rules. This case will be explored later on. A container is a block of code in Hopscotch. For example, a when container, a custom rule or custom ability, a repeat block, a check once if block, or a draw a trail block. Currently, the scope of the local variable can be set to a specific container by dragging where the local variable is declared. Since counter is a local variable, it will exist only in the container where it has been declared. The set variable block is the declaration for counter, since it is where the counter variable has been set to be a value for the first time. Since counter has been declared in this when game starts container, its scope will be set to this when container and the containers inside it. So that includes this repeat container inside. But how can we tell where the local variable exists? That is, where it can be used and accessed in code. This leads us to property 2 of local variables. A local variable will appear in the variables keyboard if it exists in the current scope. I'll use an empty increase variable block to let you see the variables keyboard. When I check the variables keyboard in the first when game starts container and in the repeat container, the counter local variable appears in the variables keyboard. A local variable will remove itself from the keyboard where it does not exist anymore in the current scope and is not used anywhere in the current scope. Counter will not exist outside this first when game starts container. A local variable's value cannot be accessed from outside the container where it exists. If I move the declaration for counter into the repeat container, counter will no longer appear in the variables keyboard outside of the repeat container. It will still exist inside the repeat container. If you have created a local variable and removed it accidentally, and it has disappeared from the keyboard, don't worry. You can just create the local variable again with the same name if you would like to use it again. Now that we understand how local variables behave, let's go back to the timer code to understand how it works. The text object will set its text to the counter variable, wait 1 second, and then decrease it by 1. It will do this 10 times since counter is set to 10. The advantage of using local variables means that they will exist only where they are being used. They will not exist in other rules where they are not being used. Let's check out property 3 of local variables. Local variables will reset if their scope resets. For example, if I use the counter local variable in a when iPad is tapped rule without declaring it, it will reset to 0 each time the iPad is tapped. The text object will always appear to be 1 when the iPad is tapped. This is because counter is reset to 0 every time the iPad is tapped, and then increased by 1. If I use the counter local variable within a repeat block without declaring it, it will reset to 0 each time the repeat container runs. The text object will always be 1 in this case. If I use the increase variable block with a local variable, in a scope where the local variable has not been declared, the local variable will start with the value of 0 in that scope. Case for custom blocks, custom abilities and custom rules. Local variables within custom abilities and custom rules have their scope restricted to within the custom block. This is because custom blocks can be used in different parts of code, where the local variable may not exist in that code. You can create custom abilities and custom rules with parameters. The parameters are local variables which exist inside the custom ability. As a summary, local variables can have their scope set to be to a specific container. You can choose which container by changing where the local variable is declared. How to merge local variables. Usually, when local variables are used in different when containers of an object, they are separate since they have separate scopes to each other. It is possible to merge local variables in different when containers so that they refer to the same value. Here is how to merge local variables. Use local variables with the exact same name in different when containers. Declare the variable outside the when containers. A merged local variable behaves like an object variable that exists only for this object when used, and not necessarily all objects. Let's explore the case of using merged local variables to store health for a character. In this example, the local variable health is the same variable used in the when game is playing rule and when self bumps spike rule. Health has the same name in both rules, and it has been declared outside the when containers, so it has been merged. Since it is a merged local variable, health will exist for frog, since frog is using this code. It is almost similar to an object variable, because you can use it in different when containers in frog's code. Where a merged local variable is different to an object variable is that it will not appear in the object variable's keyboard for other objects that do not need to make use of it. Health will appear in the variable's keyboard only when frog is using it, and not for other objects that don't need to store health information. As a summary, to merge local variables, you can set them to have the same name, then declare the variable outside the when containers. When do you use local variables versus other variables? If you want variables to exist only for a specific object or within a specific container, you can create a local variable. For example, you can use local variables when you're working with repeat containers and need a variable that will mainly be used only for the repeat container, like a counter. You can use local variables to store information on things such as velocity, health, and other information that is specific to just certain objects and not all objects in the project. That's it for now. If you have more questions, you can refer to our articles on help.gethopscotch.com or email us at help@gethopscotch.com. Happy hopscotching!